Hello everyone. So in this topic today, we are talking about the objectives of Information Technology Act 2000. We will be discussing the features of IT Act 2000 as well as the application of IT Act 2000 and some of the acts to which the IT Act 2000 do not apply. Now coming to the introduction first, the United Nations Commission on International Trade Law, popularly which is known as the UNICITRAL Model Law. This UNICITRAL Model Law, it was adopted on the electronic commerce in the year 1996. And the purpose of adopting the Model Law on electronic commerce was to bring uniformity in the law of different countries when it comes to the electronic commerce related activities. The General Assembly of the United Nations, it recommended that all countries must consider this model law before making changes to their own laws or their domestic laws. So accordingly, India also makes its own law in the form of the Information Technology Act 2000. Now, the draft of the IT Act, it was first made in the year 1998 in the form of the E-Commerce Act 1998. But at that time, it was not passed by the Parliament of India. And it was redrafted in the form of the Information Technology Bill 1999 and was finally passed by the Parliament of India in May 2000. Now coming to the objectives of the IT Act 2000. Now the objective of this act was to give a legal recognition to any transaction which is done by electronic way or by the use of the internet. So for the first time, this act, it recognizes or it gives the legal sanctity to the transactions which were done by the use of the internet. Secondly, to give legal recognition to the digital signature for accepting agreements with the use of the computers. That was also one of the objectives of IT Act 2000. Then to provide facility of filing document in the online form. And that is what we see nowadays, that there are so many forms. When we talk about the government forms, they are filed by the general public in the online mode. So that was what is the effect of the IT Act 2000. Then the other object of IT Act, that was to stop computer crime. Not to stop, we say that it cannot stop, any act cannot stop totally the crimes, but to curtail to some extent the crimes which are related to the computer world or the world of the internet. Now, other objective of this act was to give legal recognition for keeping the records in the online form or in the electronic form. Then finally, to amend the certain existing law in the form of Indian Penal Code, Reserve Bank of India Act, and Indian Evidence Act. Also, these acts were amended to give effect to the provisions of the IT Act 2000. Now coming to the features of Information Technology Act 2000. Now all electronic contracts made through secure electronic channels are legally valid after this act comes into force. Legal recognition for digital signature, that is also made legal now after this act was passed. Security measures for electronic records and also for the digital signature. Now the act itself lays down a certain essential modes which are to be adopted while the digital signature, they are to be created for the purpose of security of the documents. Then appointment of adjudicating officer for holding inquiries under this act. And this act also makes the provision for establishment of cyber regulatory appellate tribunals. Now to handle this provision is made to handle all appeals which are made against the orders of the controller or the adjudicating officer. Further, digital signature, this act lays down, the IT Act 2000, it lays down that while creating the digital signature, the use of asymmetric cryptography and hash function to be used. Now, further, it also provides for the appointment of controller of certifying authority to grant the license as well as to regulate the working of the certifying authorities under the Act. Now, this Act also applies to the offense and the contraventions which are committed outside India, and that what we have discussed in the previous slides, that for giving effect to these to the existing laws in the form of IPC or the Indian Evidence Act. Now these acts were also amended so that the extraterritorial operation that may be granted to the existing laws. Then this act also provides for the provisions for the constitution of the Cyber Regulatory Advisory Committee for the purpose of giving advice to the central government and to the controller as well. Now talking about the applicability of IT Act 2000, now according to section 1 subsection 2, this act extends to the entire country including the state of Jammu and Kashmir. And further, it also provides that the IT Act 2000, it shall have the extraterritorial jurisdiction. Now, section 1, subsection 2, it also lays down, and section 75 of this act that also correspond the provision which is there under section 1, subsection 2. And it says that the act is applicable to any offense or contravention which is committed outside India if the conduct of the person who is doing certain crimes and the impact of that particular crime that happens within the Indian territory and within any computer system or computer network which is located in India, then in such cases also the IT Act shall be applicable on such person. Now there are certain acts to which the IT Act 2000 do not apply. Now according to section 1 subsection 4, this act do not apply to certain acts, and these are: first one is the negotiable instrument other than the checks, so this act do not apply to that. Then this act also do not apply to the power of attorney, which is defined under the Power of Attorney Act 1882. This act again do not apply to a trust as defined under the Indian Trust Act 1882. This act also not applies to a will as defined under the Indian Succession Act 1925. And further, any contract for sale or conveyance of immovable property or any interest in such property, such activities shall also not be considered under this act. So that is what we have in this topic. So thank you all.
Thank you.